Today on SEBA On Demand, we're going to talk with Acquanetta Warren, who is the Fontana mayor and just a breath of fresh air in terms of politicians. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thanks for having me.
I just want to say on behalf of our membership first, thank you so much for coming to the first annual Peace Officer Day at the Capitol.
Thanks for inviting me.
For people who don't know, it was basically the first time that hundreds of peace officers went up to the Capitol to have their voice heard. So how was that experience for you?
If you know me, you know that I support law enforcement because they support us. They keep us safe. And once you're safe, you can do anything. And so I was not aware that peace officers had never had their day. You know, you see the cities, you see the county, all the healthcare workers, every association, every group, any special interest has a day in Sacramento. So I was shocked.
That was the first time we came together as a profession to represent both labor and management. So to have someone there like you, it just meant so much walking the halls with us, wearing the T-shirt. I just have to say thank you publicly on behalf of the association because it was huge.
It gave me a chance to understand even closer just what type of trials and tribulations that all of you are going through. And we as a public, we support you. As you know, I did Facebook Live that day and I could not get over the amount of likes and people actually coming on. Don't go back without us, particularly our faith-based community. So I was really proud to be there.
Yes, you and I talked about that day and I was gonna ask you about it anyways, but I'm glad you brought it up because there's kind of this misconception, I think, that, or at least we might feel it, that we're out on an island, that we don't have the support. But what you had mentioned that day, especially from the faith-based community, really bolstered the fact that our community supports public safety.
You know, Lolita, I tell you, I come from an environment, you know, I grew up in South Central LA, and I grew up during the Watts riot. You know, I saw all the fires as a little girl being on the front porch, seeing the one grocery store we had burned to the ground, and people running down the street telling us they were going to burn down our houses, and my dad having to get a note to get to work. He worked in Canova Park to get through the National Guard and the police, and people's fear of the police. But my mother and father were adamant about we not being that way, and they made sure that we respected police officers. And we were actually explorers at 77th Street Police Department, which was a big deal. But what you all don't understand is that people do support you, but because you are highlighting the what we would call society's problems, and you're out there doing that omen's job trying to make us all safe, you probably think based on all the news reports and press that everyone's against the police, and that's not true. And that day, it showed.
A lot of people talking about bridging the gap, and I think talking to you, there's probably less of a gap than maybe we think. But part of that is just making sure that the community understands that we are the community.
Exactly. And when I was in Explorers, Officer Dosser was our mentor, and he made sure we got whatever we needed to be successful. My sister and I went up to the 77th Academy, which was a big experience for us. You know, we're talking kids sitting one day at the Watts Riot, the next day up in the police academy. It taught me that these are our parents, these are our uncles, our cousins. They have feelings too, and they too have families waiting for them to come home at night.
Outside of law enforcement, your background, your upbringing has shaped a lot of, obviously, a lot of who you are, but a lot of who you are as a leader. Tell me a little bit more about that.
My dad was big on don't whine, don't cry about things that aren't right, fix them. I grew up in a fix-it atmosphere. And so I decided I wanted to just help. And I got involved any way I could from elementary school all the way through college. I was student body president at every school I attended. I was one of the first African Americans bused for LA Unified School District. Imagine that, to integrate LA Unified School District. So I come from a background to fix it.
Sometimes when you come from somewhere else and you come out to a new place, there's a little bit of a culture shock, but you've completely embraced the fact that the Inland Empire has its own unique strengths and you are working to form them and to forge them. And tell me a little bit more about how you do not want to be considered LA now.
Well, I grew up in LA and it's my hometown, but Inland Empire has this unique character and identity, and we need to embrace that. We are the economic engine for the whole state. And everyone knows that, but yet we still cower down to L.A. County. And I'm constantly telling L.A. City Mayor Eric Garcetti, you don't speak for us, Eric. I love that guy, by the way. But the bottom line is, Inland Empire, we have learned how to do it right. That's why people are moving out here. Our housing is better. Our safety is better. There's so many things we're doing. We have all these jobs. Okay, they call me Warehouse Warren, and I wear it proudly. The whole idea is those warehouses or those big, large boxes are not all warehouse logistics transportation. The majority of them are manufacturers made in Fontana, made in California, made in the United States. What can go wrong with that? Nothing. It communicates to jobs. But our young people haven't been prepared to actually take those jobs. And guess what? Those same counties that always try to look down on us are sending out people here to work here, and by us, vice versa. So the whole idea is to bring people together, recognize that identity, and use it to our benefit.
I know in Fontana, you know that economic growth is what spurns public safety, which is what spurns business and the whole cycle. I mean, I've heard you talk about it numerous times as part of your leadership.
What people don't recognize is that all these departments under these elected officials are supposed to function, even at the county level. And if we don't create an environment where our public knows where to go to get an answer, that's what creates the dissension and divisiveness that we don't need as a public. So I try to make sure that we're always educating our public on what they need to know and how they can access services.
You said there, even at the county level, as if it were a lower level, which I think a lot of people see, right? There's the national, state. But I have heard you talk about how it is at the local level where people need to know that they're the boots on the ground. They know their city's best. And that's where the real leadership and the outcomes come from.
Right. The county is the top, as far as I'm concerned. And then you have each local city. And we have to work together. And all the resources come through the federal government, through the state, to the county. And then the county needs to learn even more. They're doing it, but they could learn better how to work with us more carefully to make sure we understand the services the county can offer. No one is an island in this whole equation. Although a lot of cities try to be that island, no. We have to work with our county supervisors to make sure that our public gets their services.
Are there any closing thoughts you want to leave us with?
We've got to get back to what matters, the basic. And part of that is the education. I really am anticipating developing this coalition I put together. It's the Fontana Mayor's Education Coalition, where we're all coming together. Fontana is unique in that we're serviced by 5 school districts. So it's important that we all work together to make sure our children are proficient. Remember, that's our future climbing behind us. They're our shadow.
Well, thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me. And I just love what you're doing.
Thank you.